Thank you, Mr. President. I move notice of motion, private business number 16, standing in my name, namely that I have leave to introduce a bill for an act to amend the National Parks and Wildlife Act 1972.
Do I need a seconder for that? That's a question. Say aye against and no. The ayes have it. Bring it up.
Bill for an Act to amend the National Parks and Wildlife Act 1972.
Thank you, Mr. President. I move that the bill now be read a second time. And I rise today to bring back a piece of legislation that I previously introduced, that is still regrettably necessary. Unfortunately, we still have people out in our community who feel that they have the right to be cruel to animals, and so here we are. Further, we appear to have government departments who are unwilling to enforce our existing laws and protect our native animals. And so here we are. I commend the work of dedicated wildlife carers, and in particular Bridget Stevens from the Wombat Awareness Organisation, for their dedication to protecting and advocating for our beloved wombats. The bill I have introduced to the chamber today would make it explicitly illegal to bury wombats alive. I think most people would be shocked to hear that such legislation would be necessary, but it is. The southern hairy-nosed wombat is the faunal emblem of our state, and though it was once widespread in semi-arid regions of our state, the species is now restricted to isolated populations. Wombats are supposed to be a protected species in South Australia, and technically they can only be killed under certain circumstances and with a permit. However, often during farming or construction work, they can be seen as a nuisance, and in particular because of their burrows. So those burrows are filled in, sometimes quite deliberately, with the wombats still inside. These wombats are then doomed to die a slow and horrible death. This is a clear sign that our laws are inadequate and not properly enforced. The current provisions under the National Parks and Wildlife Act 1972 allow a penalty for killing a hairy-nosed wombat without a permit at $2,500 or 6 months imprisonment. And I want to be clear, even with a permit, it is not permissible to kill a wombat by burying it alive. Yet it is estimated that hundreds of wombats are killed by being buried alive every year as their burrows are bulldozed and nothing is being done to prevent this. Wombats cannot dig themselves out of bulldozed burrows as they have nowhere to put the soil. They become entombed and they suffocate. If the wombats are not helped, they can live for up to 21 days once their burrows have been filled in. This is a truly horrible, slow, and painful death. This form of eradication can be stopped by protecting wombat burrows by law. Wombat burrows house many other species of wildlife, such as echidnas, small native mammals, reptiles, and birds. They are ecosystems within their own right. So many of our beautiful endangered wildlife rely on wombat burrows for habitat. And they too are buried alive with the wombats. The killing has to stop. We need to find a better way to coexist with these beautiful animals, and we need to actually protect them, not just pay lip service that we are doing so. Wombat burrows are sometimes seen as a nuisance to landowners, but this is in no way, shape or form an appropriate response to a perceived nuisance. Wombats are iconic native animals, and this cruelty is unwarranted and unacceptable. At present, it is the responsibility of the Department for Environment and Water to ensure that wombats are not being killed in this way. But the experience over many years has been that reports of wombats being buried have been met with indifference at best. Indeed, I'm reminded of the incident in 2017 where, when reports of wombats that were being buried alive were raised with the department, they issued a statement that investigators, quote, do not believe that any wombats are trapped underground, end quote. But then seven dead wombats had been collected from the property. The day after that statement was released, we were further informed by the then Department Duna, now DEW, that the advice that they had received from some unidentified wombat expert was that, quote, any buried wombats would be able to dig themselves out, end quote, and that they had removed 9 wombats, dead wombats, from the property. The inconsistency and the unwillingness to take action to rescue buried wombats was disappointing at best, and continues to be disappointing today. In fact, that is a very tame word for those actions. Even last year, I shared with this chamber the disturbing story of wombats being buried alive once again, this time at Lake Carlett. That incident was reported to the RSPCA, who were unable to assist as the wildlife matters were under the department's jurisdiction. It was then reported to the department, who indicated that they would investigate. It was then reported to SAPOL, who were unable to, as the footage didn't show the wombats being maimed or injured. What an utterly ridiculous situation. And this is not the first time I have raised the issue of wombats being buried alive. Despite repeatedly being told that wombats are protected, and that this is technically illegal under the Act, the wombats are still being buried alive, and no one is being held responsible and no one is stepping up. So with this bill, I want to act on the calls that have been made for some years by the community, and in particular the calls of the Wombat Awareness Organisation, and make burying wombats alive and destroying their burrows explicitly illegal. Mm-hmm. People who are responsible for such horrific killing of wombats do need to be brought to justice. We must ensure that we have the right tools to properly prosecute those who do break our laws, and the laws must be explicit in condemning and preventing animal cruelty. There is never an excuse for such senseless and cruel killing of animals, especially when the animals in question are our precious and threatened native fauna. And it's only by showing that there are significant repercussions to these incidences of animal cruelty that we can start to pretend them properly. With that, I commend the bill to the chamber.
Mm-hmm. Call the Honourable Mr Hunter to take the adjournment.
Is
that seconded? Seconded. Put the question. Those for questions say aye. Against, say no. The ayes have it. The Honourable Franks, in order of the day for next Wednesday's sitting. Is that seconded? Put the question. Those for questions say aye. Against, say no. The ayes have it. Clark. Well, the Honourable Mr Hunter.
Notice of motions number 17 and 18 be made ordered for the next Wednesday of sitting.
Is that seconded? Put the question. Those for questions say aye. Against, say no. The ayes have it. Clark.
Notice of motion.